needs that to happen. You know, I know a lot of people talk about the pitch clock coming. I think that's coming. Just to get the game at a faster pace, because there's so much information. Think about what these players are doing. They're trying to slow the game down because they have so much information. The hitter doesn't want the pitcher to speed up. So even though we talk about the pitcher's job is to deliver a pitch in a faster fashion, it's the hitter that's going to have more of an issue with it than the pitcher does.
Doesn't have time to think.
Right.
Over to first base, and back is McNeil. I wonder if they did put the pitch clock in, how many pitchers would have trouble with it?
I think it'd be a small percentage. You have less than 2% of pitchers that have a very meticulous way of doing things. And then, of course, with two strikes and runners out, the pitcher clock kind of goes away anyways.
This one is fouled back, and we'll do it again, 1-2. Kenny, your thoughts on the pitch clock getting a lot of conversation this week?
Well, Jason Stark of The Athletic wrote an article this week, and he analyzed what is going on in the Low A West League, where they have a 15-second pitch clock, and the time of game there has reduced by 21 minutes. 21! Showed you what a pitch clock can do. Maybe it won't be 15 seconds, but baseball is looking hard at it.
That's significant. A game last night here at City Field, it was a 5-4 game that took 4 hours and 3 minutes to complete.
Yeah, I think the information up here, though, is so far greater, and there's so much more to do up here than in single A. I would like to hear those. I would like to see the triple A numbers where it's just closer. If that was significant, then I would say, okay, great, we can shave off some of those minutes. But the whole idea is starting the minor leagues to teach everybody how to go a little bit quicker about their business, and then it's not such a big drastic change when they get up here.
First and third, a 1-2 pitch is popped up, foul off the right side as Ramiro and Miller both give it a look, but it's back in behind the Mets dugout. This has been a taxing inning for Nola.
You know, I hope they play around with things in spring training like they have in the last couple. I think it's great that you can have some ingenuity and create something. I selfishly would like to see every spring training game with a man on second every inning just to see what would happen if the philosophy would change. If not, if everyone's still trying to, you know, shoot for the moon and not move anybody over, maybe not. But I would be interested to see if they started with just to see what could happen when you've got a little more action out there versus, you know, I know it would never come into play. I'm not advocating every inning starting with a man on second, but you got to start with the philosophy of things before you can.
McCann strikes out, and Nolan does indeed get out of the jam. It was a taxing inning, but he gets close. The Mets will lead the Bears. 1-0 Philadelphia.
Star 行动版新式登场。
运动比起日本起步晚了二十几年，因此不管在预算、法令、个人助理制度或社会观念，都有待急起直追。
是因为核心有收费违反医疗法，如果事实明确，北市卫生局将开罚5-20。
那以上通过全民英检初级，究竟他们是怎么？
Insiders across the league get exclusive in-depth interviews with baseball's biggest stars. Subscribe now at MLB.com/podcasts. Third inning, and it'll be Aaron Nola who leads it off here for the Phillies. Well, the right combination, sponsored by Subway, had the really cool chance to face his brother Austin. With the parents looking on, and he struck him out on three pitches, impressively enough. Who do you root for? Your dad? You get the Philly shirt on the outside, you get the Padres shirt on the inside, but you got both on, but that's a pretty strange place to be.
Can't imagine what that would be like all the years growing up, and all the times they did that. They did it for real.
First time ever.
And
in the big leagues, not the backyard, though.
Exactly. You talk about bragging rights.
Was a career 159 hitter. He's got 7 hits and 44 ABs this year. And he leads it off in the Phillies' third inning. Carrasco's thrown 30 pitches.
Hard foul off to the right.
You know, I'll never forget, it wasn't my brother, obviously, but facing Tom Glavine, when you play 15 years with a guy, you never think you're going to face him.
Practically your brother.
Practically, and I'm like, I'm going to hit this guy. Like, I watch this, you know, every hitter go up there and every hitter come down. And so I've got bases loaded, and I'm at the plate, and I'm like, stay back, stay back, stay back, stay back. I couldn't do it. His changeup, I grounded into a double play, couldn't do it, and I finally realized, I'm like, all right, Glav, I get it. I get it, all those 300 wins.
Wow.
Every hitter went up.
包括精神障碍、智能障碍、肢体障碍也是跨障别。这一间可以学习织布、制作小饰品，有人学一个月，有人学一点，已经可以提前上衣。
You got my brother, kind of like my brother that, you know, for years we played together and never thought. We always talked. Here's what I'm going to do to you if I ever face you, and vice versa. Didn't quite work out that well.
One down here in the third as Nola struck out, and here is Herrera as Carrasco goes second time through the order. Making an interesting point earlier about why so few pitchers now go third time through, because they featured all their stuff the first two times through, and guys have seen it all by this point. I mean, what kind of approach would you have taken in this instance? I mean, I know you were talking earlier before the game, we were talking about a couple different instances where you do nothing but sliders for the first time through.
Yeah, you've got to change your, like, I'm amazed that there's reports on hitters that always take the first pitch. I'd say to a hitter, why don't you make the scouting, change the scouting report? If everyone's giving you a free pitch, but they stuck to their game plan. The one thing that, again, teaching pitching or learning pitching like we had to is, you're facing guys 3 and 4 times. You can't, unless they have such a big hole and they don't change, you have to keep something in case you face them in a crucial situation.
The end of the shift on the right side. Baez on the backhand gets it there in time. It's played by Javi Baez, who has spent the bulk of his career on the other side of the infield. Out here at Citi Field and with the Mets, and get back in play against the grand.
That was a great play, and this guy has been known, even when he's struggling at the plate, he never struggles there. A magician in every sense of the word. When he's in the field, he's impacting the game. But to kind of finish that up, it's like, now there's one style of hitting, one style of pitching. So pitchers are on, they don't have to deviate or change because the hitters aren't changing. So it's this tug of war that, you know, you go in with your best stuff and then you let the rest of the guys come in with their best stuff. And so therefore you have a regression in innings pitched and limit in how many pitches they make. So everything gets condensed and you need more people to be successful. in a vacuum, that kind of works in one game at a time approach, but in 162, it shows itself. You know, the asset of a team and the teams that win championships, they rely on their horses. Very few times will you win a World Series without your starting staff doing their job. Very few. And so today, they're given the information and kind of like the answers to the test, and they're just going out executing regardless of the feel for what it calls of your eyes. They have so much information now that that's how they're attacking the game.
Carrasco ahead here, 0-2. Segura, who got to him in the first inning, and drives this one to left field and deep. McGill going back, and again it's gone. Segura homered in the first. He homers in the third. They're both solo shots, and the Phillies are on top 2-0.
Well, what was biting the Phillies pitching staff on an 0-2, their offense took care of it on an 0-2 pitch. And I can tell you right now that I would like to have a redo for Carrasco.
Two hats are going on. Two home runs for Gene Segura. 13 and 14 of the year. That was more of a line drive home run. But the Phillies on top 2-0 with two outs here in the third inning, and Bryce Harper standing in. Let's get a look at both.
Yeah, this one was a mistake only because he's such a good first pitch, first ball hitter. And unfortunately, on an 0-2 pitch, he gave him a backup slider. And that is the best formula for a ball to leave the ballpark, because the spin and the angle which the bat connects, the backup slider just doesn't usually work.
Grounder by the mound from the shortstop spot. Lindor's going to hurry, and he gets it there just in time to get Bryce Harper and to end the inning. But Gene Segura is homered for the second time and put the Phillies on top 2-0 after 2.5 from Citi Field.